You came for Demon Souls?
Yes, I did. So I'm here to teach you how to set up your computer to play Demon's Souls in less than 5 minutes in a super simple way. There's three things you're going to need to get started. One, your computer and some software. Two, an actual PS3 copy of Demon's Souls and a DualShock 4 controller with the cape. The first thing we're going to do here is we're going to go to the RPCS3 page and download the actual emulator. So you can go here and click this and the emulator should pop right up and download it and install it. Excellent. Now that we have it installed, what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to download the latest PS3 system software update, which is 4.82 at the time of this recording. I've left links in the description below of where you can purchase the game, where you can get the emulator and the software and the ISO for the game at your convenience, so that you don't have to go trolling around the internet to find it. And the final thing that we're going to do here is we're actually going to download the game. It's split up into parts, part one and part two, about 5 gigabytes and 2 gigabyte files separately. They're pretty quick to download as long as you have a good internet connection. You could also use a Megashare file to download it in one sequence altogether, or you can find a torrent of it online. As a final option, you can rip the disc onto your computer. I don't have a CD drive on this laptop, so I wasn't able to do that. I did use the file here and it worked just fine. Now that we have our emulator installed and all our files downloaded, go to RPCS3 and actually open it up. The first thing that we're going to want to do before we even try to touch a game is go into install firmware. So from here, you're going to want to do that ps3update.pup file that you had. Now that that's installed, and it might take just a few minutes, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to actually set up your computer to play as a PlayStation 3. The first things first, we're going to go into our CPU. Going through this as quickly as possible, the PPU decoder and the SPU decoder, you want them on the fastest recompilers that you can get. So hit these two right here, put this on auto, and load only the library from the PS3. The additional settings, we're going to enable the thread scheduler and enable the SPU loop detection. I think at this point it sets this up by default. You don't have to do this on your own anymore, which is very simple. Second, we're going to go into the GPU tab and we're going to change our renderer to Vulkan. If you're running one of the GTX 1060s and above, go with Vulkan and you should be able to run the game a little bit more smoothly. If not, go to OpenGL and keep it there and you should still be able to run it. Make sure that your graphics device is actually set up to your graphics card. If you're going to use your regular Intel, it's not going to run very smooth at all. So now this is where some people are going to deviate. If you want to record this video, then you're going to keep yourself at 80%. Otherwise, you're going to want to go and bring yourself to 100% here to play the game as if it was on an actual PS3 machine. You're going to keep your resolution scale at 16:16. This is how to get the game running exactly as it is on a PS3. If you're going to be running a 4K machine, you can run this up to 300% and you can change this guy around here as well. We're going to keep it for these purposes at 16:16. Now, I know you want to hit play. Not yet. We have one more thing to do. Let's set up the pads. Plug in your controller at this point. Your computer will most likely receive the DualShock 4 as a wireless Bluetooth controller, and it'll download all of the necessary drivers. If it doesn't, go to Google, do a quick search on DualShock 4 or DualShock 3 drivers and download those. So by default, player number one is going to be set to keyboard. Switch to DualShock 4 and hit the configure button. If this area right here doesn't move when you move this, it means it's not working. So we are getting a precise readout right here, which means that this works just fine and we are ready to go. Double click the file for it to load up. You'll see a bunch of information in the log file down there and it'll start to load up all of the shaders from the actual disk. How cool is that? We got the Demon's Souls logo loading up and everything. And as soon as you see the pop up and you hit that X button for okay, you know that everything is gold and you're about to play Demon's Souls on your PC. One final thing to note here, when you are supposed to enter your name, the PlayStation 3 generally loads up a small keyboard for you. This isn't going to do that. What actually happens is as soon as you hit X, this pops up and you're actually able to type in a name right here, which is pretty sweet. Now, some people complain that audio wasn't working for them. If that's you, shoot me a message and I will help you out with that. As long as you're subscribed and you comment, I can help you out setting this guy up to run on even the worst of toasters. So let's figure it out. Let's check out some gameplay. If you have any issues, be sure that you're subscribed and comment to me so that I can actually help you work through any of the issues you might have. I know a lot of guys have been having audio issues. I've had none. So if you have this weird glitch where you can only listen to the game through headphones, shoot me a message. Keep in mind, as soon as we get those private servers running, I'm gonna kill you. Take care, guys. I'm Dominic. Have a good one.